Adjectives.
Okay.
Right? So we're going to talk about adjectives today. And as I told you before, that in Hindi, whenever you are talking about possessive adjectives or verbs, you follow a pattern which is there. And what is the pattern?
The masculine singular, masculine plural, feminine, all the same.
That's right. So you have the masculine singular, which is always going to be a ending. You have masculine plural, which is always going to be a ending. And then you have feminine singular or plural, which is always going to be e ending. Right? So this is how we are going to see that here. So the topic that we are doing today is adjectives. And when we speak about the adjectives, as we just said, we have a masculine singular, we have a masculine plural, and we have a feminine singular and plural. A pattern that we see in most of the things in Hindi. Not all, but most.
Okay.
Right? So when I'm talking about the adjectives, this table is going to be very helpful to understand it. So if I say the first one, big. So for big, my masculine singular is bada. Bada. And this brings the same sound. Remember we spoke about this sound. This is one letter in Hindi which has the two sounds. R.
R.
R. So it is bada.
Bada.
It's the same that we saw for ladka. Right? Ladka. When we said a boy, remember?
Mm-hmm.
He said, ladka. So this is a very prominent sound which has the R sound, R and D together.
It's just like really fast RD. It's the same sound. Because
it's one letter. It's not two letters. It is, since it's one letter, the sound is, it's together.
Right.
R. Right? So, bada. So what will be the plural?
Bade.
Bade. And what will be the feminine? Buddy.
That's right.
So when I say small.
Chota. Oh, that's little. Sorry. Okay.
Thoda is little. That's yeah. Right. Small is chota. So plural?
Chote.
Chote. And feminine?
Choti.
Choti. So if I'm talking about something long or tall, then I say lamba, plural.
Sorry.
Plural.
Lambe.
Lambe, feminine.
Lambi.
Lambi. When I say fat, this is mota.
Mote.
Mote.
Moti.
Moti. For thin, we would say patla.
Patle.
Patle.
Patli.
Patli. Absolutely. For new, we say naya.
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 Nayi.
Nayi, very nice.
Can you say the masculine plural again?
Naye.
Naye.
You can have a Y there or you can just have an A there. So you may either say naye or you could say naye, one and the same.
But the others, it's...
This is
why it's true for all of them.
That's right.
Okay.
Naya. Naye. Nayi.
Or...
Naya. Naye. Nai.
Okay.
Right. Then when I'm saying old for a thing, this is purana. Purane. And purani. And you know what is good?
Acha.
Acha. Right. So acha, ache, achi.
I have a question about this one.
Yes, please.
So, I mean, constantly people are acha, acha.
Huh.
Do they just tend to default to the masculine, if they're just responding to someone like,
absolutely.
Yeah, that's good, that's
yeah,
good, they just say
achha. When you're not knowing what object you're talking about or in general, achha is like, you know, yes, okay, fine. So that is how it is used. So you always say achha, you never say achhi.
Okay.
Only when in a sentence you are trying to talk about a feminine object, then you say achhi. Achhi kitab, you know, for example.
So if someone's like, oh, I did this and this and this video.
Okay. Yes.
I hear your husband say it a lot. talking to a...
Yeah. And for bad, you have the word bura. It's different, huh? This one is bara. And this has an oo sound. So bura.
Bura.
And then you have bure and